Welcome, I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about hookworms, causes, signs, symptoms, and tips. So I'm not new to this subject, that's why I can say it with a straight face, but hookworms is something that we need to be more aware about. It is a type of roundworm and can commonly be picked up by walking barefoot outside, which is something that I actually do recommend for your health, which is very good for you. But the problem with the hookworms is that they can then go into the lungs and then eventually hook on to the intestinal walls, and they feed off of our blood and our good nutrients. So one of the things about hookworms that people don't realize is that you can be asymptomatic and not really know that you have hookworms. And I have experienced people in my practice over the years that eventually had this investigated. They found out that they had hookworms, and they had probably had them based on the size and the impact on, you know, evacuating these from their body, but they probably had them for years and years without even knowing it. So some of the most common signs and symptoms of having hookworms include some abdominal pain. Now remember, you need not have any of these symptoms, but these would be some of the common ones. So abdominal pains, not feeling so great in the digestive tract. There could be itching on the skin, as the skin and the lungs are related to one another in traditional Chinese medicine, so that's an interesting, you know, correlation there, as well as a cough, of course, because they may be in the lungs. You could have rashes on the skin as well, an overall sense of fatigue and lack of energy, because one of the things that hookworms will do is rob you of your iron. So they feed off of your iron, making you deficient in iron, and this is one of the things to definitely have investigated. If you've got some of these symptoms and you chronically have an iron deficiency, and as it's evaluated in your blood work that there's low iron, that, you know, I always look at the root causes to why that iron is low in the first place. So this could be one of the things that may have been missed in terms of diagnosis. So what do we do about these things? Well, some of my tips for dealing with intestinal parasites and hookworms and other ones, other intestinal worms as well, is to definitely stop feeding them. So one of the things that you can start to eliminate from the diet is sugar. This is something that, whether it's candida or the intestinal worms, they tend to love, especially the refined sugars. So eliminating this from the diet is difficult, you know, especially if you are addicted to sugar. I do have an entire show addressing the sugar addiction problem that a lot of people have, so make sure you check that out here on YouTube. But really, limiting that sugar intake is an important thing to do, as well as using herbal medicine. So some of my favorites include black walnut. I love oregano for killing parasites. I love cloves as well. So it can be very helpful at killing the eggs and the larvae of intestinal parasites, as well as helping to dislodge the parasites from the intestinal walls. And that's important with that combination of those herbals to be able to allow for those, you know, not so friendly organisms, the hookworms, to dislodge from the intestinal wall, because they literally hook on to your intestines, and that's one of the reasons that you can have them for years and not, you know, necessarily know it, and they are difficult sometimes to eradicate. Another tip is to use probiotics. So whether that is a great probiotic supplement, which is important, so we'll share some links below to some products to help you, but also probiotic foods, so live foods in your diet, and incorporating things like sauerkraut, kefir, as well as kombucha is great to drink. So some live foods in your diet will help to keep that healthy ecology, that healthy gut microbiome, which is so important as well. So I hope that you learned something new today. Today I talked about hookworms, causes, signs, symptoms, and tips as to how to get rid of these unfortunate creatures that could be living in your gut. If you do have questions or comments, I'd love to hear from you, so please put that in the comment section below. Be sure to share this video as well. I'd appreciate a huge thumbs up, and subscribe to my channel. If you're new here and you're not yet subscribed, please subscribe. Click that bell to turn on your notifications so you're always notified of my newest and latest uploads, which happens every single day of the week. And remember to always take good care of your health and do it naturally. Thanks for watching. Oh,